8:10 on your Tuesday. I'm David Settle. We're back with Laramie Live on KUWB, and my pleasure to welcome back to the program. He's the executive director from the University of Wyoming Alumni Association. Keena Fry's in studio with me. Good morning. How are you today?
I'm very good, and getting ready for this 94th homecoming
at the
University of Wyoming homecoming. You bet.
Wow, 94.
Only in the fall since 1922. Sam Knight moved it to the fall.
So this used to be a spring exhibition?
Absolutely. Did it around graduation. And in 1922, they determined to move it to a football game. Hmm. And they were up to the last minute. They were paying folks $10 to come out and help to get the grandstand set up. And it was right up to game time, as I understand it. So the cowboy lore reflects it that way, so I'm going with it. But no, since 1922, it's been on a football weekend.
Well, here it is this weekend. It looks like weather-wise is going to work out, knock on wood, for us. I got going with the big event last Saturday, and you and I were talking about that before, and some great participation.
600-plus students, David,
wow.
And hundreds of projects. And I just really shout out to our students, our community partners. That really is student-run. I mean, we promote it as the Alumni Association, but all the credit really goes to our student government and student leaders and administrators that support that, and then our community partners. So great way to kick off. This is the fifth year now of kicking off homecoming that week, that Saturday before. So really special.
Well, let's hope that they got all the projects, and I think the weather held out just long enough for them to do that. I know they were starting at 9 a.m. on Saturday, and I got back to town because I was in Sheridan on Friday, and I got back to town. It was still pretty good weather, even after the volleyball match got done about 3 o'clock or a little after that. So it was still pretty good. So if they were able to squeeze it in by about 5,
that
was pretty good. We've got a lot of activities going on, and there's a lot of things going on campus. As I was talking, you heard me earlier talking about the scavenger hunt gets going today for the students, and there's a lot of things on campus for the students. But what about those of us that are not students? What's going on this week in homecoming week?
Well, I'll tell you, Friday is a big day. Each of the colleges will have something going on. And if you can just go on our website, the homecoming website, and you can see all the colleges doing open houses and those kinds of things. Friday in particular, if you're a college of business major or an MBA degree, I really would encourage you to come to the College of Business atrium at 4 to 5:45 on Friday afternoon. Our new College of Business Dean, David Sprott, we've joined with him to put on a big event. We have music and speakers and food and beverages and the like. That's going to be a really special one. Our nursing alumni chapter is doing an event 4 to 6 that day. Native American alums and prospective students are joining at 6:30 that night as well. There's just a whole lot. If you're on campus for Friday, I would encourage you to stop by the Alumni Center in the Gateway and pick up your discount to the bookstore. You get 1% for each year you graduated, up to 25%. Our 50-year group, 1968, they get 50% this year. But stop by and say hello. We've got some goodies out there, and really encourage you to do that on Friday as well.
Well, and that 50th reunion, do you get a lot of people to come back for that?
We have 88 this year. It's really
good.
This is one of the strongest ones we've had, and it's really a good group. And they've got guests and stuff, but we're really excited about that. Major General Susan Palmerlow is the guest speaker. She's a 1968 graduate. She's also one of our distinguished alums that's getting recognized on Friday night. And she has just had a remarkable story. And she'll be sharing, Dr. Nichols will be speaking, and the like. So we've got a good group there. And then Friday night, we recognize those distinguished alums. And that's a big event. And then Saturday, the parade at 8, that needed to be because of the early start time. But then we joined with the Foundation for Cowboy Coffee and our all-alumni reunion right after the parade.
Okay.
And full breakfast kind of items and lots of beverages. Coach Bowl will be by at 10:15, the band at 10, the team walking through and Cowboy Walk at 10:30. So a lot going on.
How have you seen this expand to include more activities in your tenure here?
Well, we've added, it's really kind of coming from either the colleges or alumni networks. These expanded individual reunions keep growing.
Okay.
And already, College of Pharmacy next year wants to do one, its reunion on that Friday. So I think those individual affinity areas that folks have had their closest tie, you know, the fraternity and sororities have always done a wonderful job inviting their alums back, and they've got some private things, but now they also participate more broadly. I mean, particularly in the parade and in some of these reunions and the like, so they're not siloed by themselves, but fraternities and sororities have a real rich history in supporting homecoming and those activities.
Parade, as you mentioned, starts at 8 a.m. I'm going to assume kind of the typical parade route. We started 9th and Ivinson. Kind of take us through the parade route, just going down. So
yeah, you go down to 3rd.
Go west on Ivinson to 3rd.
And then up Grand to 14th.
Okay,
and,
all right.
And cut in right there. And we're really excited, you know, with Governor Meade and Carol Meade being our Grand Marshals, his last year as governor, and they were just excited to lead the parade this year. I really appreciate them. I mean, this is obviously in some ways very insignificant relative to what all he's done as a governor, but they really embrace UW traditions, and we just are so grateful that they would choose to lead the parade this week. And then we have 90 entries this year. We thought it was going to be down a little bit because we had to move it up an hour and a half, and we had 95 last year, so 90 this year, so we're excited about that.
That's not too bad. And both the governor and the first lady graduates of the University
absolutely
of Wyoming,
so that's absolutely
pretty cool. That is pretty cool. Now, what else we got going on? What else are some of the highlights that people need to be aware of, I guess, Keener?
Well, I think this Saturday morning, really coming to the Gateway Center and being there, and I tell you, you know, we need you there with Coach Bowles speaking and the team come through. They need some encouragement. It's been kind of rough the last few weeks, and we need Pope fans to show up. Like I said, our band will be there. We got great food that morning. There's plenty to go, and then go over to Cowboy Joe's activities. They do a wonderful job with their tailgating activities that will start about 9:30 in their case and go to right up till game time.
Yeah.
So really hope that you'll be there. I would encourage Janet Killian and her shop do a great job doing our homecoming mums. We turned that over to them a couple of years ago, and that's just been much more availability, selection, pricing, and everything like that. So go see Janet down there and pick up homecoming mom for your special person in your life there.
Nothing wrong with that. And again, it is homecoming week. We're talking with Keener Fry, executive director from the University of Wyoming Alumni Association. All kinds of different activities going on. And you know, I've gotten, because I was my college is in the College of Arts and Sciences, I've had all kinds of information sent to me. So that kind of backs up what you were talking about with the colleges have their own things and different.
Each of them have stuff going on pretty much throughout the day.
And so Friday is a very, very busy day, but there's no shortage. And then obviously want to cap it off with that parade and then everything at the Gateway Center right after the parade and leading up to kickoff, which is at 12:30 on Saturday for the homecoming football game. Anything else that's coming up this weekend? You mentioned the discounts. What do we need to do? You mentioned stop by the Gateway Center.
You get a little card. We confirm your graduation date, fill that out, and go to the bookstore and spend a little bit of money and save a little bit of money.
They
would appreciate that.
Yeah. No doubt about that. Anything else before I let you go this morning?
I tell you, I think that's good. I encourage all of our fans to get out there to support the Pokes. We play every Saturday. You never know. You can't base it on the previous week. And we've got a great opportunity to turn the season around and get ready then to go to Border War the next week. That'll be good.
Yeah, coming up on the 26th on a Friday night down at Fort Collins. If you need to contact the Alumni Association, 766-4166, or you can catch them. UWalumni@uwyo.edu is the email address. And of course, for more information on homecoming events, uwyo.edu/homecoming. Keener, always a pleasure.
Hey, thank you, David. I really appreciate it, sir.